Hello friends, good to see you again through this video today. Today I wanted to talk about this topic. Are we going to settle in a dry land or are we going to settle, you know, in a fertile land, right? Because when it comes to selection of a land, let's say we are going to build a house, right? We always want to have a good land, right? Like, you know, we go and check out the water resources. We go and check the, you know, quality of the soil. And, you know, we check out, you know, how good that, you know, the surroundings of the place is all about. So we do a lot of this kind of a check because we wanted to ensure that we get a very good land. But today, the question before I have, you know, before you and me is, you know, if the Lord is leading us in a way where we may encounter a dry land, and if the Lord is asking us to settle us in a dry land, are we willing to do that? That is the question. And many times, you know, as the world says, what you see is what you believe. So we find it very difficult for us to understand, you know, when God is taking us through a dry land. So why is He taking us through a dry land? So how can I trust that He is going to make me, you know, sustain in a dry land? This is what the question we have. So to understand it better, I know I wanted to share some insight from the Bible today, which I feel like, you know, would help you and me also. You know, if you read in the book of Genesis chapter 13, I want to give a quick background about what is happening there. You know, here we see Abraham, when he was called by the Lord to come out of his family and his country and asked him to go to another country. So he is going through that journey. And along with Abraham, Abraham's nephew Lot also came with him, right? So they both had a lot of possessions, wealth, and, you know, they had herds and they had a lot of flocks. So what happened as they grew in wealth, you know, the shepherds between these two camp, you know, they began to fight and there was some strife coming into the family. So Abraham decided, let's not have a strife, you know, because we are all one family. So he gave Lot one choice. Like if you read in Genesis chapter 13 verse 9, the whole land is before you, Lot, so you can separate yourself from me. If you take the left hand, I will take the right hand. And if you take the right hand, I will take the left hand. So which means he said, you know, let us part away peacefully so we can go in each one direction so we don't have strife between us. So it is at that point of time now Lot is seeing on his direction. Now he is looking out, right? And Lot lifted up his eyes and saw that the Jordan Valley was well watered everywhere, like the garden of the Lord, like the hand of the Egypt and the direction of Zoar. This was before the Lord destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah. See, we all know about the city called Sodom and Gomorrah, right? Like, you know, the Lord destroyed those cities because of his wickedness. But here, you know, at the moment of decision, like, you know, Lot is now looking towards the direction of those cities because for his eyes, from his perspective, it looks so well watered. It looks very nice. You know, it looks like, you know, so fertile. And, you know, he thought this would be the best place for me to settle. So I'm going to pick up this place. This would be my destiny. So he wanted to select that which was pleasing to his eyes, which was appealing to his eyes. On the other hand, so once Lot picked up on this side, right, the opposite side of what Lot has picked, that is where now Abraham has to go. So that land looked like more of a dry and a parched land. So there was no greeneries or no water sources. But still, Abraham had this confidence that the Lord, who has promised him already to make a blessing, right, to make him a father of nations and to bless him abundantly and to be with him forever and ever. So he knew, okay, if the Lord is allowing this in my life, if the Lord is leading me towards this dry land, so I can still be assured that He is in control of everything. So I don't need to worry about this because He is going to be there to take care of me. See, today, this is the same instance we need to apply in our life also, my dear friends. You know, when we are in a moment, when we are in a moment of decision making, right, when we want to take a decision, whether are we going to be like a Lot, or are we going to be like an Abraham? Because if you and I, when we behave like Lot, right, what we tend to do, we only go by our the appealing things that our mind is, like, you know, willing to accept. right? Because when we see a land or when we see anything in this world which appeals to our eyes or which appeals to our mind, which says, okay, the mind says, okay, this is good for me, this is something good for you. So when we go by the voice of our own mind and our own understanding, sometimes we may have to end up like Lot, where Lot did not receive any inheritance. Rather than the place which he thought was the best place, eventually he saw that place was destroyed. You know, there was nothing left in him to inherit in that place. But on the other side, Abraham, though, you know, at that present moment, it looked like as if he is going through a dry land, or as if he is going through a land which is like, you know, which doesn't have any vegetation or which doesn't have anything to offer. But still, he trusted the Lord, and he eventually saw the promise getting fulfilled in his life, and he became the father of the nation, right? And father of the believers today. So this is where we need to understand. So in our life, are we going to be like an Abraham who trusted the Lord irrespective of how bad the situation looks like, or irrespective whether the land which the Lord is leading is a dry land or not, right? So when Abraham submitted to the Lord and accepted, even the dry land is okay for me, Lord, even like, you know, even though he was elderly person, he still offered the choice to Lord, right? Like, you know, he did not take the best portion for himself, but rather than Abraham trusted in the Lord. And that is why look at the blessing that the Lord is saying to him. If you read in Genesis chapter 13, verse 14 and 15 says, "The Lord said to Abraham, after Lot had separated from him, lift up your eyes and look from the place where you are, northward and southward, eastward and westward, for all the land that you see, I will give it to you and your offspring forever." See, that is the greatest blessing he inherited from the Lord, you know, when the Lord knew that he has already trusted him. You know, Abraham did not see the same way like how Lot see, right? Like, you know, Lot was, you know, willing to believe his own perspective. You know, Lot wanted to get something which was appealing to him. But on the other side, on the contrary, Abraham wanted to receive something which was appealing in the sight of the Lord, you know, which the Lord has already intended for him. So today, my dear friends, this is where we will also many times, you know, take an important decision in our life. You know, the same way if you obey the Lord and if you trust the Lord like how Abraham did, we will see our inheritance coming through. But when we act like Lot, you know, thinking that we have the ability to judge, or we, you know, are going behind the things which are appealing to our eyes, or which feel like, you know, okay to our mind, or okay to our own understanding, that is when we end up in losing the inheritance, right? So one verse says it very clearly, you know, Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 and 6, we read, this is what it goes: "Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not lean on your own understanding." See, what a great advice, you know, Proverbs is giving to you and me here, right? Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not lean on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge Him, and He will make straight your paths. See, this is the assurance for God's children. You know, when God is leading you and me through a crooked path, or through a difficult path, or maybe a dry land, we are walking through a dry land, you know, could be your job situation, could be a difficult place for you to work, or your family situation might be difficult, or like, you know, anything that is surrounding you, you may feel like as if you are in a dry land. You want to see when you are going to go into the fertile land, right? So, you know, even as the Lord is leading you through a crooked path, or like, you know, through dangerous terrain, the Lord's protection is always with you. You know, the Lord's presence is always with you, right? So He never leaves us, or He never forsakes us. And that is why Abraham was willing to put the trust in the Lord. And, you know, even though the land before him, you know, he did not know anything about it, or it may look like a dry land, he was willing to go ahead because he knew the Lord who has promised is faithful and good enough, and He is true to His promises, and He will definitely fulfill the promises, right? So, my dear friends, many times we miss out our blessings, or we miss out our inheritance, because we tend to act on our own understanding. When we try to reason out, or when we try to, you know, believe only the things that are appealing to us, or only when we see something, when we believe that is how, you know, the world operates. But for a child of God, you and I, we are called to live by faith. You know, we are called to live based on the promises of the Lord. You know, when we trust in the Lord, when we trust in His promises, that is when you will see all your opposing circumstances circumstances. You know, your circumstances may seem to be opposing you or may act against your promise, but the Lord says, if you believe in Him, if you trust in Him, you know, if you keep your faith upon Him, if you don't waver on your faith, the Lord will see you through and you will definitely inherit the promises of the Lord. You know, His word says in Isaiah chapter 43 verse 19, "Behold, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it? I will make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert." See, this is the promise of God. This is how the Lord wants to assure you and me. You know, sometimes we may wonder, Lord, I am following you. I am following your word. I am following your direction. But in spite of me following your direction, why should I go through this, Lord? Why you are taking me through a dry land? Or why you are taking me through a wilderness? So when I am going to see a fertile land? Sometimes we may run into these kind of questions. But this is what God says, right? You know, He says, "Behold, I will do a new thing." You know, even though when God is leading you through a dry land or a wilderness, He says, He will make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. My dear friends, you know, it's all about, Christian life is all about faith, right? Like, you know, it is all about how much we trust in the Lord, how much we depend on the Lord. You know, because He is our Heavenly Father and He wants His children to be dependent on Him and to, you know, be in relationship with Him. So He has got the best plan and the purpose for your life and my life. You all have a blessed and a happy day. God bless you.